So, from an entertainment perspective and a craftsmanship perspective, Eddie the Eagle is a perfect movie. It's in fact one of the best movies I've ever seen. And while I was watching it during the press screening on Tuesday afternoon, I was seriously debating whether or not I should put it on my top three list of all time. That was the internal debate I had while I was watching the film. Now you might be thinking, well, Grace, after entertainment value and craftsmanship, what's left? Where did the movie fall short? Well, much to my dismay, after the press screening, there was a press conference with the director of the movie and Eddie the Eagle himself, the real guy. And actually, at the end of this video, and in the video description, there is a link to that interview. But everybody in the press screening loved the movie, by the way, and so of course we had tons of questions. And over the course of the press conference, little by little, it became revealed to us that the movie's largely made up. For instance, here are some of the doozies. So it fails in the accuracy department, which is kind of important when you're making a movie about a real person. So, for instance, Hugh Jackman's character did not exist. Eddie actually had a number of coaches, and they only helped him intermittently during his training. A lot of the time, he was on his own. Next, Eddie's father. Eddie's father was incredibly supportive of him for his entire life, but instead they decided to turn him into someone who was a real obstacle for Eddie. Well, you can watch the interview. Eddie's fine with all of this, obviously, but I thought it wasn't a very nice thing to do to his real life dad. Even though I liked the movie, but it's hard to reconcile it with so many lies. And then here's another doozy, the final doozy that I wanted to let you know about. Eddie actually trained in the United States for a lot of his training. And instead of the movie, I guess that's why an American trains him in Germany, but they never have him go to the United States. So that's a big thing to leave out as well. And it's really unfortunate they decided to make these decisions, which they said was for the sake of the film and to have a more compelling story, et cetera, but then, they should have just called it something else besides Eddie the Eagle. Because it's like, forget inspired by true events, this is suggested by true events. Now let's push all that aside and just think of Eddie the Eagle as a fictional film, because that's what it is. As a film on its own, without having to tell the true story of Eddie Edwards in real life, it really is perfect. It's an amazing movie. Taron Egerton is amazing. Like, he was good in Kingsman: The Secret Service, and now every studio wants him as a leading man. But he proves here he is a character actor. He has range. I mean, I hope his stock just goes up. It's probably not going to go up that high because he has a big box office flop probably on his hands with this movie. It just has not clicked, perhaps because it's a giant lie. But that's really a shame because it's an amazing movie and he's amazing in it. Then Hugh Jackman is also great. This is like a tailor-made role for him. And in fact, he has a moment in the movie, even though he's playing a fictional character, where he does a ski jump himself, and it is the best on-screen moment I've seen Hugh Jackman have in his entire career outside of the Wolverine movies. It was that good. Then I also have to say that Dexter Fletcher, the director, a former actor himself, I posted the interview the other day, a number of UK BTT viewers were so happy to see him from Press Gang. But Dexter Fletcher, I can't believe this is his first studio picture. He seems like he's been making studio pictures for years. It's just so well done, and he should be on every studio shortlist, along with Taron Egerton. I would just, really check his scripts. But you know what? If it was a fictional movie, it would be great. He was right about the story structure and the motivation, et cetera, et cetera. It just isn't Eddie's story. Then I have to say that one of the best, and again, most disappointing aspects of the film is the score. The music used in the film, and I asked about this at the press conference, so you should look at this because it was such a great answer from Dexter Fletcher and very funny. But his use of music is probably one of the best uses of music I've ever seen in a movie. And he not only has 80 songs in the film, but his composer, Matthew Margeson from Kingsman and a couple of Matthew Vaughn projects, Matthew Vaughn produced this, but his soundtrack is made to seem like it was made in the 80s, and it's amazing. But here's what's annoying. This soundtrack isn't available for purchase. During the movie, I was like, should I put this on my top three movies of all time list, and should I buy the soundtrack? And I never got to make the decision about the top three because they killed that with the press conference. But only when I was making this review and doing my notes, and I was like, I better buy the soundtrack so I could say that I bought bought it, and I looked, and it's not available. They only have music inspired by the movie with just Eddie's theme on there. And you can't even just buy Eddie's theme. You have to buy the whole album with music not from the movie. So I'm just devastated that one of the movie's best qualities isn't available. It's one of the best soundtracks I've ever heard, up there with, like, Blade Runner. And I can't purchase it. It's ridiculous. It's that good. So, also, the movie has a lot of nice things to say about bullies, hard work, and optimism, and those are really important messages. So, I really feel that you should just go in with your eyes open, know that it's all made up, but I really think that Eddie the Eagle is worth seeing, because it's not only a great movie, but if you're interested at all in filmmaking, I mean, here's a wonderful example of how to do everything but make a movie about a real-life person, because they just lied. But otherwise, it's perfect. It's like, I would say it's textbook. It's so good. I just loved it so much. I was just on cloud nine the entire movie. I can't recommend it highly enough, even though I know it's a giant lie. So you can decide. I think that it would be great on the big screen. I know a lot of people will probably wait to get this until they can get it for cheaper. Just see it at some point. But it's really well shot. It's beautiful at the Olympic events, the music, the performances. Really, it's just such a good movie. So just go see it and don't believe it, but believe it. All right, so that's my review of Eddie the Eagle. Please share your own thoughts about the movie down below, and you can check out some other episodes right now, including that interview. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.